So you just get doodled.
First car out. And the Big A Graphics Rocket Chassis out of North Carolina. They call him Big A Anthony Sanders. And coming up behind him in the 4T, Rocket XR1 Cat Constructions Machine out of Knoxville, Tennessee. It'll be Tommy Kerr. Rocket Boy. Oh, Rocket Boy. 16.455 on lap number one for Sanders. 16.230 for Tommy Kerr. Sanders landing out of turn four. Can he beat that time? Not quite, as he will remain second quick so far. 16.139 for Tommy Kerr. Next machine out of Newnan, Georgia, in the 70 Auto Sales. Clemens Race Power up under the hood. Capital Race Card. Leading both the Rookie of the Year chase and the points, it's the JYD of Austin Horton. And coming up behind him in the C5 machine, one of Tennessee veterans that is doing his thing here at the Speedway in the C5 machine, is David Crabtree. So Crabtree off the pace in turns one and two. He gets it back up and rolling, so Horton's going to bring that big 434 Clemens motor down the straightaway. 16.139 on lap number one for Horton. David Crabtree clocks in fourth quick. So Horton remains second quick on the board. And Crabtree remains in the fourth qualifying position so far. So the next machine out onto the Speedway in the number 11B machine out of Kentucky is picking up a Southern All-Star win at Tennessee National Raceway. It's going to be That'll be Stacy Bowes, one of the local contenders here at the Smoky Mountain Speedway, and coming up behind him in the number 69 X, it'll be Carter Miller. Bowes goes with a 16.558 on lap number 568 on one. 16.227 for Carter Miller. Stacy Bowles, a 16.471 as he goes fifth quick. Whoa, Carter Miller to the top of the board with a 16.093. Next machine out in the number 22 out of Mount Holly, North Carolina with the Longhorn race. Rocket XR1, Clemens power up under the hood. It'll be Chris Ferguson, and behind him in the 21 RV Fleets XR1 Rocket Machine, it'll be Mr. Robbie Moses. Ah, that didn't last long. Chris Ferguson to the top of the board. 16.008. Robbie Moses, 16.390, as he goes to fifth quick. 16.232 for Ferguson on lap two. Robbie Moses faster on lap two, but remains fifth quick with a 16.156. Craig Greer, the number seven, one of the veterans of the East Tennessee area, making a trip up here, and behind him in the 201, multiple wins here in East Tennessee, is Billy the Kid. So Billy Ogle Jr., 16.427 on lap number one, putting him six quick. Craig Greer, 10th quick, 18.126 on his first go around. 16.238 for Greer. As he crosses the strike, Billy Ogle slows down a little bit on lap two to a 16.605 as he goes six quick.
You gonna leave me your phone, right? I may need to make an investment.
Next machine out and the number 50 teammates to Robbie Moses in the Fleetwood RV machine. It'll be the big buck of Shannon Buckingham. And coming behind him in the Cox Automotive Capital Race Car, Cornett Race Engines under the hood, it's the Ackworth Assassin, the All-American 400 winner. It'll be TJ Reed. Whoa, good lap. 16-1-3-2 for the big buck. TJ Reed comes in and clocks in at seventh quick with a 16-2-0-0. So Shannon Buckingham, third quick. A slight pickup remains third quick with a 16-1-0-2. Ah, TJ Reed second quick. 16-0-5-4. He goes to second quick. So the Ackworth Assassin moving up to the quick. Next machine out, the 2016 DirtOnDirt.com Cruise with the Champions Rookie of the Year. And the Rocket XR1 picked up the big win with the Southern All-Stars at the Thunder Hill Raceway outside of Lawrenceburg, Tennessee. It's midnight, Brad Skinner. So Brad Skinner clocks in with a 16-6-3-2. Next car behind him in a 31. Classic GRT man doing it out of four. He will cross the stripe. It's Skip Hart. 16-3-0-0. So good lap for the skipper. Brad Skinner, 16-6-8-3. That's a hair slower on lap number two. The Georgetown, Tennessee driver brings it across the stripe, slows down literally by the hair length on my head to a 16-3-0-8 on lap two.
UCRA, please.
UCRA Crate Late Models. You should already be in staging. You are next. UCRA Crates. We need you in staging, gentlemen. You are next for qualifying. Next machine out in the number 24H. It'll be Phil Hilton. And coming up behind him. Ah, way up against the wall out of turns four in the number 7 machine. And the Blunt's Excavating Blunt Motorsports entry. XR1 Rocket. It'll be D-Mac Donald McIntosh. 17-5-1-4 for Phil Helton on lap number one. And Donald McIntosh, second quick, 16-5-6-1 on lap number one. Eighteen-oh-nine-two for Phil Helton on lap two. Ah, Donald Mac to the top of the board. 15-9-3-8 for Donald McIntosh. So Donald McIntosh, so far the overall fastest, but he is fastest of group two so far. Next machine out with the Cornett Race Engine up under the hood in the Capital Race Car in the Sealy's and Sons form. Moultrie, Georgia driver, the Moultrie, Georgia Madman, third in Southern All-Star points in Rookie of the Year. It'll be Mr. Tristan Sealy. And behind him out of Hohenwald, Tennessee in the Masterbuilt. Phantom Race Engines up under the hood. Career high with the Southern All-Stars with a third at Thunder Hill and a career pole with him. It'll be Eric Hickerson. 16-9-9-6 on lap number one for Sealy. 16-6-8-5 for Hickerson on his first go around. The Moultrie Madman hanging it down into the middle, and he brings it down to this front stretch. 17-0-3-7 for Sealy and Hickerson. 16-6-5-1 on lap number two for Eric Hickerson. Has been set, but not for long. We still got a couple of guys coming out, and there's some fast ones. Next machine out of Cartersville, Georgia, 16-year-old Phenom driver, career second place high at Sonoya Raceway with the Ultimate Super Late Models. It's the Zach Attack, Zach Leonardi. And coming up out of turn four, right behind him, into number 11, it'll be Eddie King. Eddie King, one of our Tennessee drivers, looking to get up to that front row. But out of turn four, Zach Leonardi brings it down. 17-1-2-3 on lap number one for the Zach Attack. And behind him, Eddie King hits the strike. 16-8-7-6, that'll put him into the top five so far. Leonardi way up against the cushion as he comes off four. A little pickup to a 16.939 on lap 2 for Zach Leonardi. 16.968 in the Capital Race Car Vic Hill Race Engines under the hood for Eddie King. Next machine out in the number one Warrior House Car. It'll be Flying Ryan King, and behind him in the number five, 70 plus years young, it'll be Mr. Lamar Winkle. Ryan King just a little bit loose off the corner as he tries to keep it pointed in the right direction. He swings it up to the top side and he'll bring it down to the straightaway. 16.767 on lap one for Ryan King. 16.797 for Lamar Winkles.
Lamar Winkle used to race when I was a kid.
Nice pickup for King. 16.943 for the legend of Lamar Winkle.
Yeah, even.
Next machine out, and the number 97 machine. Haven't seen him in a while. Glad to see him out. In the GRT race car, teammate to Skip Harp is Bobby Giffen. And behind him, when it got one of those Rocket XR1 machines, it is Trip Gerald in the number four. So Giffen clocks in with a 17.230. Trip Gerald trying to hang that Brandon Shepherd high line. 17.650 for him on lap one. Good lap for Bobby Giffen as he goes to third quick. Trip Gerald, a nice pickup. He goes to fourth quick as he goes a 16.393.